My practice is more based on what I understand in human movement and the human being more than, and all of that can be applied to any kind of form or what's needed. And try to teach in such a way, and in particular, to give the students as many possibilities as possible. Each year has a specific physical composition task, and that will usually go the whole term. In the second year, it's the whole year. Other than that, the first years do a journal, so it's important for them to be able to remember what actually happened in the class and to be able to do the work outside of class. Then I see the journal and see how it's been interpreted in their mind or their way of seeing it, so we come closer together what the understanding of the work is. Another part of the program is called movement composition, where they learn how to create their own movement pieces. And that changes year by year, so the first year is usually work with one person, then alone, and in the second year they work with the props and developing like a short theater piece with the prop and through movement. And in the third year they do a physical character studies. I expect them to work outside of class on the work, and that's visible. I can see it in their bodies if they are or they're not, and so that's an important aspect that I prefer them to be doing the work for themselves. Class time isn't enough. It just isn't enough. So to come to a theater school, one has to have the desire to really want to be an actor, otherwise there would be no point. But there's other benefits of studying things around theater as well for just the general person in terms of becoming aware of who you are, what your experience of life is, and being able to articulate that, and the training, the voice, the speech, the movement is good for anybody, really, and even entering into the creativity of a lot of the other kinds of courses.